we'd like to thank Brinzy, the chick incubation specialists, for sponsoring this Mother Earth News and Friends audio article. Brinzy has been focusing on egg incubator design continuously since 1976, resulting in a wide range of egg incubators, chick brooders, and incubation accessories. Their products are designed to be long-lasting and energy-efficient, including their advanced series incubators and brooders, which feature the latest state-of-the-art digital control systems and provide instant readings of temperature and humidity to ensure successful hatches and healthy chicks. Innovation you can trust. Hello and welcome to Mother Earth News Audio. I'm Jessica Mitchell, reading All About the Heat by Marissa Ames from the April-May 2023 issue of Mother Earth News Magazine. Enjoy. Can you list the five things you need to raise healthy chicks in a brooder? Food, water, bedding, grit, and heat. The first four are simple, but the fifth gets complicated. Mimicking the warm protection of a mother hen means keeping babies at an optimal temperature, which changes week by week until they're ready to stay outside for good. And adding supplementary heat is not optional, no matter the time of year. From hatching day to that first night spent in the coop, monitoring and providing the right temperatures for chicks makes the transition smooth and keeps babies healthy. Only chicks, not chickens, need supplemental heat in winter, and only for a short time. Comfortable human homes are 20 to 30 degrees Fahrenheit too cold for chicks. The ideal temperature for chicks that are 7 days old or younger is 95 degrees, and then 90 degrees in the second week and 85 degrees in the third. Each week declines by 5 degrees until chicks are ready to live outside. To help you learn more about heat and temperature for chicks, we're diving into some frequently asked questions about them. Why can mother hens bring babies outside, even in freezing weather? Because they don't have feathers to self-regulate temperature, newly hatched chicks depend on mothers to keep them warm. A hen's internal temperature ranges from 105 to 107 degrees. Darting beneath their mother's wings when they're cold, and emerging only to eat and drink, babies thrive on the mother-to-chick relationship. It may look like babies are constantly outside, but they take short trips and then hurry back to warm up. You must provide your brooder chicks with appropriate heat sources and closely monitor them with thermometers and good judgment. How do I keep chicks warm enough without a mother hen? When planning hatchings or chick purchases, plan the brooder as well. Avoid waiting until babies arrive. Have a full setup, which includes food, water, grit, bedding, and a heat source, ready when you bring chicks home. That way, you can immediately place them in a comfortable environment and help them recover from travel shock. Each moment a baby chick is too cold is another moment its health declines. Purchase heat lamps from feed or pet stores. Experts recommend red bulbs because they're not as bright as clear ones, allowing chicks to have natural day and night cycles. Red bulbs also discourage chicks from picking at each other. Reptile bulbs are not hot enough. 250 watt varieties are most recommended. Always use a lamp setup made specifically for heat bulbs, as heat levels and higher wattage can damage desk lamps or painter's lamps. Secure the lamp well. If it falls into a brooder, results could be tragic. Always keep bulbs at least 2 feet from combustible materials. Many companies now offer safer options, such as brooder plates. These sit inches from the brooder floor, just far enough for chicks to run underneath when they get cold and go exploring when warm enough. Brooder plates never get hot enough to burn the babies, and they adjust to rise off the brooder floor as chicks grow. You can also use heated pads that lie beneath bedding, providing warmth from below. If you choose these, be sure they're rated for baby chicks, and read reviews. Cheaper knockoff brands can be dangerous, shorting out, or creating hot spots. Don't use seed-starting mats or heating pads intended for humans. And always monitor temperatures, no matter what you use. If you just brought chicks home, keep them in an area near 95 degrees while you find a heat lamp or brooder plate. And don't waste time. Get an appropriate heat source before the day ends. How do I know if chicks are warm enough? For starters, install a thermometer in the brooder to monitor temperature. But determining whether chicks are warm enough or too warm is not difficult. If they huddle together directly in the heat lamp's beam, they're colder. Lower the lamp closer to the brooder. If they move away from the beam to sleep, they're hotter. Raise it up. And if you see chicks panting, that means they're overheated and need cooler temperatures quickly. A well-set-up brooder will have warmer and cooler areas. That way, chicks can sleep under heat and water can sit at the edges, where it won't evaporate so fast. If your home temperatures range around 75 degrees, you won't need to supplement heat past 4 weeks. But in barns or garages, which may run 60 degrees or cooler, chicks will need supplementary heat until they're fully feathered at 6 weeks of age. Consult the chicken heat table, which we'll read later on in this audio article, when determining whether your chicks still need heat, and if so, at what temperature they need it. And now, here's a tip on how to measure relative humidity from Brinzi, the incubation specialists. Relative humidity is the most common measurement used in incubation, and it's a percentage of how much moisture the air can hold at a given temperature. Most modern incubators measure relative humidity, but if you have an older unit, you can calculate relative humidity by using two bulb thermometers in your incubator. Place one end of a cotton wick over the bulb end of one, and place the bulb end of the other in water. Note the difference between the wet and dry thermometer bulb readings, and use one of the many charts available online to calculate your relative humidity. Can I hold the babies or take them outside? Though mother hens let hatchlings roam freely, their warm, feathery bodies are waiting close by. A balmy 70-degree spring day can quickly chill a brooder baby. Keep this in mind when you remove chicks from brooders to hold them. Wait until little ones are older before you remove them from brooders for more than a few minutes. Chicks that are 4 weeks old cannot handle temperature fluctuations much better than 4-day-old babies. When can chicks go outside for short trips? Though they're not old enough to live outside, chicks living in brooders can enjoy short field trips, starting around the 3rd and 4th weeks. If you take them onto the lawn to peck at grass and chase bugs, stay wary of weather, outside temperatures, and the chicks' ages. These field trips will allow chicks to exercise and expand their diets. Exposure to the elements at appropriate temperatures will toughen and acclimate them, so the first night out is not such a shock. It'll also allow you to bond with brooding chicks as they grow, which will create a gentler and more human-friendly hen or rooster. When can chicks go outside permanently? Fully feathered is the point when all fluff has been replaced by true plumage. Chickens self-regulate temperatures by fluffing their feathers and creating air layers. If even just the neck still has fluff, a brooder baby is not ready to sleep outside. Until then, use the rule that newly hatched chicks need ambient temperatures of 95 degrees. Each week after, reduce that by 5 degrees. They can spend all day outside if temperatures stay within the right range for their ages. But remember, even if it's warm enough, wind and water will chill a chick. The more chicks in the flock, the more they can huddle for warmth, and you won't have to rush them inside as fast. Outside playpens should be fully enclosed, with all openings too small for chicks to squeeze through. Always cover the enclosure's top, because birds this small are vulnerable to cats and other predators. Even blue jays can enter topless enclosures and terrorize chicks. Smaller wild birds may bring diseases. Keep food and clean water available, as well as shade and shelter, which can simply be a box lying on its side. Bring chicks inside if it rains, or if you see them huddling together instead of exploring their surroundings. Also, if their daytime playpen is unsecured against predators, bring them inside anytime you cannot supervise. Try carrying them one by one, out to the playpen and back in, instead of hauling a pet carrier full of babies. This will get them used to being handled and make them more trusting. It'll let them know that being grabbed by their human owners is not something to fear. As babies near that 6-week mark, turn the heat lamp off when ambient conditions allow. Let them experience days and nights within your house or garage and acclimate to cooler temperatures. Remember, adding heat to outside coops is dangerous. Gradually transition from a heated environment to unheated but comfortable, and then to outside and sheltered, rather than going straight out at week 6 to brave the elements. This 6-week timeline has exceptions. Coccidiosis is more common when baby chicks spend time outside because protozoa can be spread by wild birds. But coccidiosis is easy to avoid with medicated chick feed and probiotics. If you see pink, meaty-looking, or bloody stools, stop the field trips for a few days and treat the babies. Wild birds also spread viruses and bacteria, and some are highly contagious. If your chicks have been sick, keep them inside a while longer after they stop showing symptoms, especially if you have older birds they could infect. The following is a chicken heat table to help determine what your chicks need and when. At 0 to 7 days, temperatures should be 95 degrees Fahrenheit. Now is not the time to let babies stay outside the brooder more than a couple minutes. At week 2, temperatures should be 90 degrees. Babies start flying very early. Be sure the heat lamp is secure and cannot be reached. At week 3, temperatures should be 85 degrees. Chicks can make short trips outside if the weather is nice and warm. At week 4, temperatures should be 80 degrees. Let chicks enjoy more time outside, but keep a close eye on them. At week 5, temperatures should be 75 degrees. Is your house 75 degrees? Then turn off the heat lamp. At week 6, temperatures should be 70 degrees. Start acclimating the chickens, letting them spend all day outside unless weather is cold and rainy. After 6 weeks, chicks are ready for outside. Fully feathered chicks can endure 30 degrees and lower. Acclimate them before putting them outside for good, and be sure coops are draft-free. Whether chicks are outside or in, always ensure they have clean bedding, food, and water to reduce stress and risk of infection. Watch how they act. Do they huddle to keep warm? Are they lethargic? Or do they happily flap around and peck the ground? Whether fully feathered or still wearing fluff, that happy flapping and pecking are your best signs of healthy, warm babies. Marissa Ames is the editorial director for Ogden Publications. She and her husband teach sustainable farming to Zambian rural villages and schools, where they've partnered with villages to trial saffron as a potential cash crop that does not compete with local farmers. Currently, she's working on sustainable methods for battling devastating armyworm infestations without purchasing pesticides. Marissa works to save a critically endangered American breed by keeping rare San Clemente Island goats. Her small homestead has a large vegetable garden where she studies and develops drought-tolerant crops, and she makes her own cheese, bacon, soap, bread, and much more. We hope you enjoyed the audio version of All About the Heat. You can reach us at letters@motherearthnews.com with any comments or suggestions. To listen to more audio articles, go to the Mother Earth News and Friends podcast and look for audio article in the episode title, wherever you listen to your podcasts. Music for this reading is So Far, So Close by Jazar. thanks again to Brinzy, our sponsor for this Mother Earth News and Friends audio article. You too can experience the Brinzy difference and maximize your hatch rates with Brinzy incubators that precisely control temperature and humidity and are made of antimicrobial materials. Brinzy ships worldwide and provides stellar customer support to answer all your questions. Hatch your chicks with Brinzy, the leader in innovative incubation research. Learn more at www.brinzy.com. That's BRINSEA.com. Thanks for listening.